Okay, so that's basically the preform from a beer bottle bottom. There's still a lot of surface on the convex side, I mean on the concave side, but that we can take that off later pretty easily. So I've straightened it enough to do pressure now, and that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to clean up these edges and do some pressure. Now this is a it's just a rock limestone, piece of limestone that I use. You might not be able to see that. The reason why I use that is because this is convex. It's not completely flat, and it won't put pressure on the ends of the point. So wherever I put pressure is always going to be a raised area. Just before this video, my previous arrowhead snapped because I was using a flexible pad. So I'm going to switch over to a non-flexible pad. I got just past the preform stage and the tip snapped off. I don't know, I might be able to nap right on the limestone. I normally use this for notching, so even though the flexible pad is risky, I'm going to switch back over because this is a little too awkward, and hopefully I won't snap the point this time. Sorry about that. Every time I try to make a quality video, it's just that much more difficult. If I don't think about it, usually I can make a video without all these interruptions, but if I'm really trying hard to make a quality video, Murphy's Law catches up to me. Okay, I think you might be able to see that better. And all I did was I turned the edge and got rid of the really fat spots on the edge, except for this one here. I'm just checking for areas that need to be cleaned up that are hard to clean up with percussion. And it looks pretty good, so I'm going to use percussion now to run some more flakes across this side here. I'm going to use my 1/8 inch diameter copper. So that side is pretty flat now. A couple areas on the other side I can flatten out. What I'm doing is I'm looking for those areas that are still not completely flat. Or areas I could thin down some more before I do the final edge work. I don't want this point to be too thin. But it's best to correct the major errors right now, or the major areas that need attention. Okay, so I'm going to use a pressure flaker to dress up the edge, and then I'm going to run flakes across this concave side. It shouldn't be should be a problem. It's not that concave right now. I took away the major area surrounding it, so it won't be difficult to run flakes across. And it'll be easier when I dress up the edge and make this more narrow. I always run flakes across the concave side last. So just short flakes. I'm just cleaning up the edge. Hope you can see that. And I'm also turning the edge toward the concave side. I gotta be careful with the flexible pad. Make sure I'm not putting pressure on the ends. That boogery spot there is because I didn't abrade before I started. Technically, that's a stack. It's a couple of step fractures right on top of each other. Not a very smooth edge, so one more pass. So I'm just going to use opportunistic platforms to run flakes across. Hopefully you can see where these flakes are traveling when I'm removing them. Now I'm trying to get them to meet up in the center, but sometimes it doesn't always work. But I think those will pop out of there once I run some more flakes. Gotta be kind of careful with these because they're sharp. I don't want to be putting, you know, digging my fingernail in really hard and then have one of those stuck in my thumb. So I'm trying to keep that as wide as possible. I don't have my ruler with me, and I think sorry about that. Quality video at its finest. So that's very close to the shape that I'm wanting for the final arrowhead. I don't think that's an inch wide, but it's almost. And all I'm going to do now, excuse me. All I'm going to do now is pressure the edges and do some notching, and then we'll be done. normally I do the tip last, but it was just bugging me. And then now I think I've taken too much off. Very, very thin now. Normally you don't want to hear that grinding sound when you're pressure flaking. You want to hear a nice clean snap. If you're hearing that grinding sound, that means you're producing a lot of little crushes and step fractures. It's not as sharp as if you have a nice clean snap like that. Probably should switch over to steel for sharpening this. Anyway, I'm going to put the notches in and that'll be it. How steel is working a lot better than copper sharpening. It produces that nice snap. And it helps too that it's so thin right there, whereas the rounded pressure flaker has a lot more surface area, so it causes more crushing. So that's what you want to hear, that nice snapping sound. Okay, I'm just working on the symmetry a little bit. Notches are a little bit off. I could take more time on this, but that's it for this one. I'll make some better ones and then I'll show you what they look like. And it's already 41 minutes, so I'm gonna stop here. I'll make some other arrowheads. I'll show you what they look like. I'll take more time on those, but I think you get the idea from this one. And I'll get my ruler and measure these bases. There's still a little bit of the original surface on the concave side, but it's not bad. Just a little spot in the middle there. Okay, that's it.